Alright guys, Spliff here, welcome back. Today let's talk about the INGCO PDB17008 Demolition Breaker. After we cleared out our yard using my new Makita chainsaw, it's now time for the next level. I'm planning to build a small hog farm and chicken coop for the eggs. And part of the plan is to dig for a cesspit or septic tank where all the waste would go, making it all tidy and not giving us angry neighbors in the end. Now here's the thing, we live near the sea. Not a sandy beach sea, but a rocky shoreline sea. And our lot is rocky as fuck. You can dig at most a foot of soil if you're lucky. After that, limestone as fuck. Sorry about that. Anyway, to make our work a lot easier, I bought a jackhammer. And the manual said demolition breaker, whatever. Again, I'm gonna experience yet another secret weapon from Silent Hill. Unlike the chainsaw, I'm not gonna cheap out on this one. I bought this from a seller who sold me a very good quality grass cutter. And since they have the same brand name, I'm quite confident. This type of product has so many names, I'll be calling it with what's written on the manual. Without further ado, here's my new rock drill. Demolition breaker, the INGCO PDB17008 demolition breaker. Let's do this. Let me start by showing you how heavy this is. If you're not confident about your strength, better ask someone to do it for you to avoid accidents. The package weighs 24 kilograms. I got this for 12,219 pesos or around $234. One of the few high value purchases I made this year. I chose this because I'll be using it for many future projects. It should last a long time, I suppose. Inside the box is a carrying case made of medium grade plastic. It looks tough enough for the job. It has two metal latches on the side, two hand grips, and caster wheels for easy transport. Opening the case gives us the manual, which includes a set of carbon brush. A set of tools. Flat and pointed chisels. And the main unit, the INGCO PDB17008 demolition breaker. The tool set includes two Allen keys, a wrench for the oil tank, an oil canister set, and these are the spare carbon brushes I talked about earlier. Now, let's set it up and put this baby to the test. Wow, it's so easy to carry. First is to set up the extension cord. A previous worker of mine custom made this extension outlet by integrating a breaker system into the circuit. This thing saved my wall outlet from melting out when using my old welding machine. I recommend you also do this if you want to be safe. Let's take a closer look at the unit. The auxiliary handle can swivel 360 degrees. position it according to your comfort. To install the chisel, pull and swivel the bolt as shown. Insert the chisel with the flat part facing the bolt. Next, pull and swivel back again to lock everything in place. The 3 meter wire has good thickness to it. It comes with an EU plug. You may want to use an adapter if your outlet doesn't support it. This heavy thing is not gonna be a practical weapon like the one in Silent Hill, but I digress. The trigger switch is located at the rear handle. It can be locked into place if you want to operate the tool non-stop. The unit is rated 1700 watts, running 220 to 240 volts. They are also offering different model with 120 volts. Impact rate and force is 1400 per minute and 45 joules, which is kinda average in this size range. Here we can find the oil tank. It has an indicator of how much lube is left. I'll talk about the details later. Before we proceed, let's talk about safety first. Unlike my previous chainsaw video where I emphasized how dangerous the chain can be, this time the only real danger is when you accidentally drop this heavy metallic thing on something sensitive like your foot. And since this is an electrical equipment, take extra care when using this near wet areas. All you need is common sense, keep away from water, use an appropriate extension cord, mind the motor's heat, yeah? And lastly, remember to rest your body once in a while. Now, time to work. After a week of hard digging, I decided to refill the oil tank when I saw that there's no more visible oil. Even though it was not printed in the manual, the INGCO shop told me via chat that they specifically recommend 1540 oil for the lube. And here's where the oil canister comes in handy. Use the included wrench to remove the oil tank cover. Pour the oil, never overfill. And replace the cap. So here's the good part. As a newbie in this area, I can tell that this is a premium quality item. Most parts are metal, making this thing super heavy. And the plastic parts and wire are also top quality. Handles are also rubberized, which gives the user great control over the demolition. The manual is also detailed and the customer support is very responsive to questions. So the bad part, I really can't think of one. I heard no complaints from the workers, and I guess it made their work a lot easier. The only thing that limits us with this unit is the fact that this is an electrical equipment, and we have to be very careful even with just a little rain. With the INGCO demolition breaker that I have, we're nearing our goal of digging 2 meters of limestone for the septic tank already. We're currently around a week of work now. If it's not for Typhoon Agaton, we could have made it in a couple of days at most. Really. On a side note, even though that this is a premium product, we still implemented caution with regards to overheating. I told my workers to run the breaker only around 15 to 30 minutes at most, then let it cool down for another 10 to 15 minutes before using it again. Cause I got hold of the breaker around that time that they are working, and it was kinda hot. I don't think it will break that easily, but I just wanna make it last. And also the oil, it should be refilled after around 50 hours of working non-stop. A properly lubed breaker is more efficient and can also last a long time. And finally, the rock drill / jackhammer / demolition breaker as a weapon. It's very impractical. So heavy as fuck. And that's my take on the INGCO PDB17008 demolition breaker. Let me hear your thoughts in the comments down below. Like and share to show your support. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this one. That's it for now. Thank you. Take care and God bless.